Well, hello and welcome to my channel again this afternoon, and we're going to continue my classical series today. And today we're going to be taking Mozart's Requiem Mass, the K626 Requiem Mass. We're going to be using the eighth sequence, which is called the Lacrimosa. Now, Lacrimosa means tearful. And we're going to take that piece of music, and I'm first of all going to play that piece of music for you, the proper classical piece. And after that, I'm going to play Evanescence, a very, very popular artist today, who, funnily enough, is classed as a metal lady. Her music, although I don't see that. I don't see that in her music, but it is there to a degree, but I would not class her as metal, as a metal lady, but... Anyway, that is what people say she is, and so who am I to argue? I'm going to show you what she did with that piece of music and with her song called Lacrimosa. And right now, before we go any further, I'm going to take you and I'm going to play you the piece by the Vienna Philharmonica, and you can hear the beautiful choral work of this piece of music, and I'll come back and talk to you a little bit later.
Thank you.
And there we come to the very beautiful end of the very beautiful eighth sequence, the Lacrimosa from Mozart's Requiem K626, I beg your pardon, with that beautiful choral, the choir there, which was performed by the Vienna State Choir. Now, the voices, of course, that were in that choir were made up of sopranos, altos, basses, and tenors. They call themselves an SATB choir. That's what they're called because they contain, the choirs contain sopranos, altos, tenors, and bass voices. And you can hear them very, very clearly there. But it was a stunningly beautiful piece of music. And the first time I heard it, it had the hair on the back of my neck standing up. Well, now I'm going to take you to Evanescence, and we're going to have a look and see what she did with the song. Now, there's a couple of things about this song that I don't really like very much. I personally think it was very, very badly recorded. It starts off very well, and you get that gorgeous bass growling sound that I just love in music. That's the kind of thing that cottons me onto to any kind of music. But then the instrumentation and the choir just drowns out Amy Lee's voice. And I didn't like that very much. And in fact, I don't think that people who recorded that song did a very good job of placing the microphones, to be quite honest with you. But anyway, it became a very popular song and many people loved it. And it's all over YouTube too. I've seen many, many versions, not versions, but I've seen many people make this song into a video with lyrics and all. So anyway, I hope you'll be able to enjoy it a little bit more now that you know where it comes from, and that it comes from Mozart's Requiem, the eighth sequence from his K626. So here we go, let's take a listen to what Evanescence did with this piece of music.
Yeah.
regardless of what you might think of that song, it's still very, very beautiful. I mean, I stand by what I said earlier on when I say that the Millennium Band and the Millennium Choir that backed up Amy Lee drowned out her voice, and I just didn't think that was a very good thing at all. So it could have pushed that choir back a bit, pushed back that band a little bit and brought her a little bit forward, but they drowned out her voice. And apart from that, I discovered, or I, with my ears, I could hear anyway, that there was quite a bit of distortion going on in that song. I've never heard any of the YouTube videos that have been done that have not shown up that distortion, so I've just come to understand now that that's the way they recorded it. Nonetheless, it's a beautiful song, and many people do enjoy it, and there are many, many videos featuring that song on YouTube. Well, now, before I go, I just have one more thing to say to you, because I'm going to play out with the Christian song, and I've got a reason for doing that. You see, Mozart's Requiem is based on a Roman Catholic Mass. That is what the Roman Catholics do. They have these requiems, these requiem masses for the dead, their family members that have died. And so they pay the priest and they have these requiem masses said in order to get them out of purgatory. There's no Catholic that likes to think that the member of their family goes to hell. They go to purgatory. And so they pay indulgences and get them out of purgatory. That still goes on today in the 21st century. Roman Catholicism has not changed at all. And Mozart's Requiem, of course, it's a Requiem Mass. It's a Requiem Mass, that's what it is. So I'm going to play out with a song by a man called Steve Amerson. And the song is called To Live is Christ and to Die is Gain. You see, because the Bible tells us that Christ is our Savior. He is the one that went to the cross. He is the one that died. He lived a perfect life and then he went to the cross. He died on that cross. On the cross he was hanging, he said, "It is finished." He was buried and he was risen again for our justification. There is no other name under heaven given to men by which we must be saved. Certainly not purgatory. If you are not found in Christ when you depart from this world, you will go to hell. If you are found in Christ, of course, your place will then be with him where he is in heaven today. So we're going to play out with this song by Steve Amerson. It's from his album called Call Upon the Lord. And the song is called To Live is Christ and to Die is Gain. And until we meet again, when I come together to show you some more classical music and how rock or pop artists that use it to facilitate what they do. Ciao for now. Bye-bye.
And to die is gain. There is no other life that I desire to claim than the life that's dead, so I might live again. No more in self to pride, for I have died. And to live is Christ, and to live is Christ. For I've been crucified, and to live is Christ, and my single thought just to hear your voice. For this I have been bought, to make my Lord rejoice. And if all that I do is bring joy to you, then let my life be poured an offering to the Lord. And to live is Christ, and to live is Christ. I've been crucified, and to live is Christ. Let my life be a fountain of your blessing. Let my life be a fragrant sacrifice, that the hurt and bruised may know the God that loves them so. Forever let my prayer be and to to die is gain. There is no other life that I desire to claim than the life that's dead, I might live again. No more in self to pride, for I have died. And to live is Christ, and to live is Christ. I've been crucified, and to live